Welcome in Nina Khrushcheva. She's professor of international affairs at the New School of New York. She's also the great-granddaughter of Soviet Premier Nikita Khrushchev, who passed in 1971, Nina, and was known to some extent as being the architect of de-Stalinization of then-Soviet Union, now Russia. What do you think he would make of the events of today?
Hi, Kelly. Thank you. I don't know. It's hard to imagine because he was the one who actually resurrected Kiev and Ukraine after World War II. He was the first secretary of the Communist Party of Ukraine as a republic within the Soviet Union, and he was responsible for building beautiful city of Kiev and other places. And I think he would shiver and be horrified, like we all are, seeing that another leader of Russia now is bombing Kiev, bombing the nation, chart that he says is the brotherly nation of Russia. I'm looking at this footage and I mean my emotions of course cannot be possibly comparable to the horror that Ukrainians are going through, but I just cannot imagine that we Russians are bombing that amazing city that was the beginning, the protest state, the Kievan Rus, the beginning of both Russia and Ukraine.
Would he have, and again, this is the point here, not to bring him back to life, but would he have supported the idea that Ukraine belonged to Russia, that it didn't deserve an independent status?
I can't say it. I don't know. And I would imagine not, because he was a huge proponent of Ukrainian independent existence. I mean, he was absolutely a Soviet leader. And as a Soviet leader, of course, the Soviet Union, communism would come first and every nation or national interest would come second, because he would think that all national interests belong to the Soviet Union. But I think the brutality with which this all has been unfolding, and you and I talked about it after 2014, after the annexation of Crimea by Russia, and he already then, I thought, would be firmly horrified that in 70 years since he was in power, when he himself actually sent tanks in 56 to suppress the Budapest uprising in Hungary. He would be horrified because he would say that 70 years later, we still haven't learned a better way. But he would also, I think, I really believe that he would fully, absolutely support Ukraine's independence. And it has been an independent country for 30 years. It's not an appendage of Russia. And what Putin is doing now, actually, he probably thinks he's expanding his imperial reach. But actually, what he does now, in addition to ruining Ukraine, he also now has ruined with sanctions and his actions and our shame for that, he has ruined lives of 140 million of Russian people.
It's interesting, Nina, I saw Peggy Noonan reference this over the weekend, that she supports the idea that George Kennan had in the late 90s when NATO was expanding eastward, and Kennan was extremely concerned about it and thought it would actually provoke the wrong kind of response by Russia, one where they felt as though they were under threat and would ultimately respond sort of the way that we're seeing them respond now. And I wonder what you would make of NATO's expansion eastward and whether it now seems like his warning was prescient or not.
He was. I mean, and I was his research assistant, actually, in Princeton in the 90s. And I wrote my own piece about 2 months ago exactly on that subject. I even have documents that he wrote to Strobe Talbot at the time, Undersecretary of State, and he shared them with me saying, what do you think about this? How he thought it was absolutely wrong to expand NATO. And I think I agree with him. I think it was a wrong idea. But I think last Monday when Putin recognized Donetsk and Luhansk republics and then the next day decided to send troops and now essentially occupy Ukraine, I don't think it's even relevant anymore, because this response was absolutely not warranted. That was such an over-top, violent, and completely illegal and immoral and unmodern response that Kennan probably wouldn't even say that Russians did what he said he would do, because that's too much of what Russians have done. And I